Hello students, so this is part 3 of unit 6, which is based on the second chapter of this unit, that is based on nanotechnology. We have completed the first chapter of unit 6 in the previous two parts. I hope you might have completed it from your side also. If not, just start your studies now. That is required. It's high time. Okay. So, first we will see the syllabus, what is there in this chapter. That is the first point we will start with, the introduction to nanotechnology. What is the meaning of this word, nanotechnology? Okay. Then as per your syllabus, you will see the meaning of quantum confinement and the meaning of surface to volume ratio. Then in details, we will study the properties of nanoparticles, and only three properties are there in your syllabus, that are the optical, electrical and mechanical properties of these materials. And the last part of the chapter is related with the applications of nanoparticles, and only these four applications are there in your syllabus. In details, they are there in medical field, then in electronics, space and defense, and in automobile industries. So for this unit, the weightage is of 9 or 8 marks as per your syllabus. So you may have 6, 4, 3 marks questions from this unit. Okay, so that I will tell. If I am taking 1 nanometer, the total number of atoms present are 10. Instead of 1 nanometer, if I am taking 10 nanometer, then the number of atoms will be 10 into 10, that is 100 atoms. And instead of 10 nanometers, if I am taking 100 nanometers, so number of atoms will be 10 into 100, that is 1000 number of atoms. If I am taking 1000 nanometer, then I will have 1000 into 10, that is 10,000 atoms. What it means, if I am using a nanometer scale, up to 100 or thousands of nanometers, there are countable number of atoms present in the material. Okay, so if I am making the material with a dimension of the order of hundreds of nanometers, I can count, I am having only some countable number of atoms present in it. While in bulk material, in a centimeter or a millimeter distance or micrometer distance also, there are uncountable number of atoms present, right? So what it is observed that given these materials are made with this much dimensions, nanometer dimensions, as the number of atoms are getting reduced drastically, the properties are quite different. The properties of that materials are very different as compared to their bulk counterparts. So it is observed that these nanometers are having some specific different properties as compared to bulk counterparts, and the properties are long lasting. Long lasting means they are not changing with the environment, they are remaining as it is. So that's why nowadays these nanometers, they are finding large number of applications in various fields, and that we'll see in the end part of this chapter. Okay, so what is the meaning of nano? It is 10 to the power minus 9 of some unit scale, and 1 nanometer is very small unit. It covers a distance covered by 10 number of atoms kept in a straight line touching each other. Okay, so in 1 nanometer there are 10 number of atoms, in 100 nanometer there are 1000 atoms, and so on, and in 1000 nanometer there are 10,000 number of atoms. So in nanometer scale there are countable number of atoms, hence the properties of the materials are changing drastically in case of nanometer range. Okay, it is also observed that the properties of this nano in the nano range, they are more dependent on size. That means if I am changing the size from 10 nanometer to 9 nanometer, the properties will get changed. Even if the element is remaining same, suppose if I am taking silicon, okay, the silicon is semiconductor in bulk form, okay. So in nano form, it is showing some different properties. That means if I am making a silicon with 10 nanometer dimension, okay, so at that point, if it is having semiconducting properties, at 9 nanometer, it may show insulating properties. It may be an insulator. So it depends. Okay, so just by changing the dimension of the material by 1 nanometer, 1 nanometer se kam kar diya, the properties are changing drastically. Okay, so the properties are long lasting and the properties are more size dependent at nano range. Okay, so you just go through this slide, or everything is written there. Next slide. Okay. For example, the properties are size dependent. Here I have given the example in the first line, CDS, cadmium sulfide nanoparticles. They are showing variation in color. In bulk form, it is having yellow color. Okay, so this color is changing to, the color remains yellow till 10 nanometer scale. And if I am changing the size of the particle, CDS nanoparticle, to some 7 or 8 nanometer, the color changes to orange, then it is changing to red, and finally at 2 nanometer it is becoming white. Okay, so just by changing the dimension of the nanoparticle of CDS, cadmium sulfide nanoparticle CDS, if I am changing the diameter from by 1 or 2 nanometers, the color is changing. What it means, color is related with optical properties. Okay, so the optical properties of the these nanoparticles, they are changing just by changing 1 nanometer of dimension. Similarly, in bulk form, gold appears yellow. As you know, gold is yellow in appearance, okay, yellow in color, but in the nanoparticles of gold, they show red colors. So the optical properties of these materials, they are changing at nanoscale, and as the dimensions are changed, the properties are changing. This is this I have given for optical properties. This example, it is observed that all the electrical, magnetic and mechanical properties of the materials are also changing at nanoscale. Okay, they more depend upon their size of the nanoparticles and on their shape. Okay, so these are the nanoparticles. So any materials, if I am making a material, so material has is having three dimensions, length, breadth and height. So the materials having any one dimension or any two dimension or all the three dimensions of the order of nanometer range, that is up to 100 of nanometers, those materials are called as nanomaterials. So the materials having any one of its dimension or two dimensions or all the three dimensions of the order of nanometer or hundreds of nanometers, the materials are nanomaterials. Some examples are given here. The first type is quantum well. Okay, so if I am just reducing the length of this, if the height and the breadth is of the order of micrometers, and if the length of the that material, if it is of the order of 100 nanometer, so what will happen? Height and width is large, but here one dimension is reduced to 100 nanometers. So what type of structure I will get? I will get a well like of structure. So that material is called as quantum well. So this is the example of nanomaterial, quantum well, in which only one dimension is of the order of nanometer, it is reduced. Okay, in case of quantum wires, so if the diameter of that wire, if it is of the order of 100 nanometers, whereas the length, if it is order of micrometers, so here what I am doing, I am reducing height and breadth. Okay, so diameter is becoming of the order of 100 nanometers. So what I will get? A structure of wire. So that wire is called as quantum wire. So this is the second example of nanomaterials. Then if all the three dimensions are reduced to hundreds of nanometers or some nanometer scale, then what is the length, breadth and height? So I will get a dot like structure, right? So that is called as quantum dots. Okay, so there are these three types of nanomaterials are there, just by reducing any one, two or all the three dimensions to a nano range. Okay, so nanomaterials are these materials having dimensions of the order of any of its dimension of the order of nanometer. Okay, so what is nanotechnology then? The nanotechnology is that branch of science which deals with the study, that is the research and application of nanomaterials in engineering and science. So that study is called as nanotechnology. Okay, so when we are using nanomaterials in research and when we are studying their application, when we are using these materials in engineering field for various applications and in science field, and that is nanotechnology. Okay, so if when we are using these materials in engineering or in science field, it is observed that the properties are long lasting, and that is they do not get changed with environment or nearby forces. For example, you might have seen this stained glass windows in old churches, which are very colorful. The churches are very old, but still the color of that glass is not changed. The brightness is as it is. It is not changing. It is not changed with time. Why? Because these glasses, they are having nanoparticles embedded in them, or that whatever paint is given on that glass windows, that paint is made from the nanoparticles. That is, the plate is having a particle, nanoparticles having dimensions of the order of nanometer. So if the that particle is made having dimensions of the order of nanometer, in presence of this atmosphere, the dimensions are not getting changed. So if the dimensions are not getting changed, the optical properties will remain as it is. So that means if it is appearing yellow in color, the color will remain yellow throughout its life. Okay. So the properties are long lasting because it is very difficult to change the size of the particle. Unless until if you are not applying any very large forces or if you are not giving any heat treatment, it is very difficult to crush the particles below 10 nanometers. So the whatever properties that particles will have according to its dimensions, that properties will remain as it is with it. Okay, next slide. Okay, so we will see in this slide, we will see the meaning of quantum confinement and surface area to volume ratio in nanomaterials. So let us see what is the meaning of quantum confinement. Quantum confinement. If I am reducing the dimension, suppose if the length of the material is of the order of 100 nanometers. So what happens? The electrons are restricted to move only in 100 nanometer range. They are not able to move freely. They can move freely in towards height and breadth region, but they are restricted in this side, in along the length side. So what we can see, the electrons are confined in this region. They are not able to move freely in that material along the length. Okay. So if they are not able to move freely along the length, the electrons are confined, and this is called as quantum confinement. So it is the confinement of the electrons or restriction in the motion of randomly moving electrons in discrete energy levels rather than in broad energy bands. What it means? If I am reducing this length in this direction, I will not get energy band structure. I will get discrete energy levels in that direction. Okay. So here along height and breadth, I am having energy band structure. But in this case, along this side, the electrons are traveling through discrete energy levels. So the properties will get changed. Electrons are getting confined in this region. So that is the meaning of quantum confinement. Electron is a quantum particle, that you know. So it gets confined within that region. So as formation of energy bands is not favorable in nanomaterials and with change in size and shape, the energy level also changes. Okay. So because of this quantum confinement of electrons, electrons are not able to move freely, and as in that direction, we will not have energy band structure favorable. So the properties of the material changes. Okay. Now what is the meaning of surface area to volume ratio? Suppose if I am taking a particle in the shape of a sphere. Okay. So what is the surface area of a sphere? Surface of area of the sphere is given as 4 by 3. Okay, what I have, okay, sorry. This is something wrongly written here. The surface area is 4 pi r square. Okay, you just change this. Instead of this surface area, you write there volume, and volume ki jagah surface area. Okay, that is wrongly written. So surface area is 4 pi r square and the volume is 4 by 3 pi r cube. Okay. So if I am taking the ratio of surface area to volume, so what I will get? 4 pi r square divided by 4 pi r cube upon 3. So this 4 pi r square will get cancelled with the denominator 4 pi r square. This 3 will go in numerator. So the ratio comes out to be 3 upon r. Okay. So the value of the surface area to volume ratio is 3 upon r. What is r? That is the radius of that nanoparticle. Okay, that is, what is r? It is the dimension of the nanoparticle. So if r is reduced, that means if the dimension of the nanoparticle is reduced, the surface area to volume ratio will increase. What it means, all the atoms, if this dimension is reduced, r is decreased, more and more atoms will come to surface. Instead of, they are going to the inside part of that material, they will come to the surface. So in case of nanomaterial, on reducing the dimension, large number of atoms are there on the surface, and because of the presence of large number of the atoms on the surface as compared to its inside part, the energy, surface energy increases rapidly. And because of this, the nanomaterials, they are chemically very reactive materials as compared to their bulk counterpart. Because more of the atoms are present on the surface, the charges are present on the surface, Okay, that is electrons and the nucleus potential and all. That's why they becomes very reactive in nano. So this is the meaning of quantum confinement in surface area to volume ratio. So you just read it out again at home, all these slides. Okay, next video, next slide, sorry. Properties of nanoparticles. So only three properties are there in your syllabus, and the first one is the optical properties. Optical properties are related with the light. Okay, light is which wavelength of the light will get reflected more, which wavelength will get absorbed by the material more, and all. Okay, so when the wavelength is getting reflected, that color we see from that material. Okay, for example, gold is yellow in bulk form, whereas it becomes red in nano form. What it means, in bulk form the gold is reflecting that color more, okay, because white light is incident and that color is reflected more, and in nano form red color is getting reflected more. Okay, so why this is happening? Okay, in order to explain this variation in color in nano range, various theories were given. So first theory was considered as the GMI theory, which was given in 1908, actually, that is before this making of nanomaterials. That theory was given and it was based on Maxwell's equations. So that theory, some part of that theory scientists are using to explain this phenomena, variation in the colors of these nanoparticles. Okay, so according to this theory, suppose if I am having this material, nanomaterial of dimension x, here it is shown in figure, okay, and if a light of intensity I0 is incident on it, then the outgoing intensity will be different. That is but natural, because the atoms of that material, they will absorb some of the incident intensity and some of the intensity will get scattered by these atoms. Okay, so the outgoing intensity is always different. Okay, and according to this GMI theory, the outgoing intensity is given as I is equal to I0 e to the power minus mu into x. What is x? The distance traveled by the light in that material. Okay, that is the thickness of that nanomaterial. Here this mu is called as the extinction coefficient, and this extinction coefficient, it is given as n upon v into c extinction, where n is the number of particles in that medium. Okay, so this material is made by the particles, so n is the number of particles in that medium, v is the volume of that particles, and c extinction is called as extinction cross section. This extinction cross section basically depends upon the absorption coefficients and the scattered coefficients. So how much light is getting absorbed by the particle and how much light is getting scattered by the particle. Okay. So this theory, it explained clearly the variation of nanoparticles, the variation in the color of nanoparticles till 10 nanometer size. So how the color is changing. But below that 10 nanometer size, if the material is made from bulk to 10 nanometer size, so if its color is changing, so this theory was able to explain that, okay, why the color is changed from yellow to red at 10 nanometer. Okay, but below 10 nanometer, if the particle size is reduced, this theory was not able to explain it correctly. Okay, so in order to explain that variation in color below 10 nanometer, one more model was given, that is the Drude model. And in this Drude model, dielectric constant of the particles were also considered for the calculations. Okay, and in this Drude model, electrons were considered as the plasma. And again, the details of these models and this theory is not in your syllabus. So only whatever I have given in these slides and whatever I am explained, that is more than enough to write for the answer. Okay. So this Drude model was able to explain the properties of some of the materials, but again, still there is no complete theory which can explain the variation in the colors of all the known till this time, all the known nanoparticles. It's 10 nanometer, below 10 nanometer, it is very difficult to explain the variation of colors of these nanoparticles. Okay. The variation in optical properties of semiconducting nanoparticles, they were explained in some different way. This variation in the optical properties of the semiconducting nanoparticles is explained on the basis of the energy level diagram. According to one of that theory, in bulk form, we are having energy band structure. Okay, but when the atoms are getting reduced at the nano scale, as the atoms are getting reduced, the energy band structure is not favorable. Instead of that bands, again you will have discrete energy levels for all these countable number of atoms. Okay, so because of the formation of these discrete energy levels, which again is getting changed when the size of the particle is reduced further. So this discrete energy level structure, it is continuously changing as the size is changing. Okay, and when this discrete energy level structure is changing, the transition of the electrons from one level to another level, it will change, and accordingly the optical properties will change. Okay, so it is observed that as the energy gap increases, the absorption peak shifts towards higher energy. That is, higher energy means high frequency value. High frequency value means lower wavelength value. So if the energy gap is increasing, we will have lower wavelengths, and if the energy gap is decreasing, we will have higher wavelength. Okay, so this leads to shift in the absorption sector and change in the colors of the particles. So if the gap between the energy levels, if it increases, what it means, the peak shifts towards the higher energy value. Okay, higher energy means lower wavelength, and if the energy gap in between the energy levels decreases, it will shift to the higher wavelength value. Okay, so these are the optical properties, that is the variation in colors, which was explained little bit with the help of GMI theory, Drude model, and for semiconducting materials on the basis of discrete energy levels. Again, the detailed explanation is not required for this part. Okay, next slide. Electrical properties. Okay, so electrical properties are related with the flow of current in the material, that you know. So if we see conductors in bulk form, so on conductors are having high conductivity and they obey Ohm's law, that you know. So if I am applying potential difference plus minus across a conducting wire, okay, so the electrons will get directed in one direction towards the positive potential, and when the electrons are getting directed, I will get a current. Okay, so V is equal to IR relation obeys this conducting wire. Okay, so as the voltage, as shown in this figure A, as the voltage is increased, the current increases. Okay, now if I am applying the voltage in reverse direction, if I am putting positive on this side, negative on the other side, the current increases in that direction. Current will go in the opposite direction. Okay, as the previous. But if I am making a nano material of this bulk form, of this conducting material, nano form, if I am making a nano form of this bulk conducting material, then I will get this type of IV characteristics, which is shown in figure B. I will look. Okay, so this is figure B, y-axis I, that is current, on x-axis voltage. Okay, so what I am observing, just at the crossing point of the two axes, that is at the zero voltage, I am not getting any current. Okay, that is true. If I am not applying any voltage, I will get zero current. Okay, but after, when I am increasing the voltage in this positive or negative direction, okay, that means if I am applying potential, positive potential on this side or on that side of the material, I am getting zero current. The material is conducting. What it means, the electrons are not able to move onto the one side. They are not getting attracted towards the voltage till the voltage is not becoming E upon 2C. Here plus E upon 2C, on this direction minus E upon 2C. Okay, suddenly when the voltage is E upon 2C, the current increases to some value. Okay, and then again it is remaining constant till the voltage is not becoming 2 into E upon 2C. Okay, then again the voltage, as the voltage at 2E upon 2C, the current increases. Then again it will remain constant till 3E upon 2C. So in this case, what I am getting, a staircase like structure, which is called as Coulomb staircase. And around the zero voltage, I am getting a zero current. Zero current region. This is called as Coulomb blockade region. Okay, so in the IV characteristics of this material, nano material, which is the conducting material in the bulk form, it is having a Coulomb blockade region, the zero current region near the zero voltage, and a Coulomb staircase structure. The current increases in steps. Okay, so why this is happening? This is because if we want to measure the current, we'll have to apply potential difference across the nanomaterial. Okay, so usually if I am giving a normal metallic, thin metallic wires across the material, as the dimension of that material is very small, the two wires may get potential, or the metallic wires, they will get joint with each other. Okay, and the circuit will get break. Okay, so what I will do, I will put the two metallic dot across the material, and the material will and the material is kept in between that two metallic dots. So the metallic dots together with that material in between acts like a capacitor. Okay, so unless and until the potential of that capacitor or the energy of the capacitor is not E into V, that is E into E upon E square upon 2C, okay, the electrons will not flow in between the two metallic dots. Okay, when only when the energy is E square upon 2C, the electron will flow. In terms of voltage, energy is given as E into V. So unless and until voltage is not plus minus E upon 2C, the electrons are not able to move from one point to one metallic dot to the other metallic dot. Okay, so when the voltage is E upon 2C, suddenly one electron will come, it will move on to the other side because of the moving of that one electron, or tunneling of the single electron we can see. Because of the tunneling of single electron in that capacitor, I will get some current at E upon 2C. Now, as the voltage is E upon 2C, still it remains, the current will remain constant, because one electron, it will need E upon 2C voltage to cross that gap in between the two metal electrons, or to overcome that material length or dimension. Okay, so when again the voltage is becoming E upon 2C plus E upon 2C, that is 2E upon 2C, only one electron is passing through and I am getting that much current value. So I am getting constant current. Suddenly when the voltage is becoming 2E upon 2C, two electrons will get tunneled. The current increases because it is due to two electrons. Okay, that way the that current value will remain constant because the current is due to two electrons tunneling through the material. Okay, and again it remains constant when the voltage is 3E upon 2C, three electrons will get tunneled. So this current increases because of the tunneling of the electrons through the material. That is called as quantum tunneling. So what we are observing, in order to explain these properties, properties of nanoparticles or nanomaterials, we need quantum mechanics to understand. This Newtonian mechanics is not applicable for these type of materials, because this is related with the electrons tunneling, and basically dimensions are very small, and you know that quantum mechanics is applicable to the materials having very small dimensions, but it is not with the bulk. So usually what happens, this is one thing, and second thing, as compared to bulk materials or polycrystalline bulk material, the electrical resistivity of nanomaterials is very high. Why? Because when the atomic dimension, this size of the material is reduced, large number of atoms are present and electrons has to cross from one atom to, when they are giving current, they have to go from one atom to next to next to next to, they have to cross this gap. In between the two metallic dots, so they will pass large number of atoms which are situated in that material. So at the atomic boundaries, the electrons may get scattered. Okay, so because of the increase in the atomic boundaries, the electrons get scattered, and hence the resistivity of that nanomaterials increases. Okay, next slide. These are the electrical properties. Next is the mechanical properties. Mechanical properties are usually related with the hardness, strength, modulus of elasticity of the materials. And mechanical properties depends upon the composition of the material and the bonding between the atoms of that material. Again, it also depends upon the impurity element present in that material. Okay. So what they are observing, that if the material size is reduced to nanoscale, the material is not becoming polycrystalline. What is the difference of difference between polycrystalline and single crystal? In case of polycrystalline materials, we are having small regions in the material in which the atoms are oriented in one particular direction. Okay, so that small region in which the atoms are oriented in one particular direction, that regions are called as grains, and the boundaries in between two different grains is called as the grain boundary. Okay, so in one grain, if the atoms are oriented along x-axis, in the next grain the atoms are oriented along y-axis, and the boundaries in between this first grain and the second grain is called as grain boundary. Okay, so if large number of grain boundaries are there in grain boundaries, okay, in grain boundaries the atoms are randomly oriented. So if the atoms are more randomly oriented, the hardness of the material decreases, it becomes brittle in case of bulk form. Okay, if large number of grain boundaries are there, that is if the material is polycrystalline, okay, then grain boundary increases, and because of that brittleness property of the material increases. But if the grain boundaries are less, that means all the atoms are oriented in one particular direction, then that is called as single crystal. So in case of single crystal, the grain boundaries are very less or negligible. It's not possible to have negligible grain boundaries in case of bulk form, but okay, the grain boundary number is reduced. So material is hard, very hard, as compared to polycrystalline material. It is observed that when we are reducing the dimension of the materials to nanoscale, the nanomaterials are acting like a single crystal. Okay, that means their hardness increases drastically. So because there are less number of grain boundaries, so it is shown in this figure, last figure, at bulk level. If the size in micrometers, the hardness increases if the grain boundaries is reduced. This is on x-axis grain boundary size, okay, size of grain boundary hai. So yadi grain boundary ka size, yadi just a minute, size of grains, okay, so if the size of grain is increased, the hardness increases, okay. But in this case, nanometer range, if this is particle size, if the particle size is decreased, that is left side towards 0h, 0x, 0x's, the hardness increases, okay. In case of, okay, so this is related with, that was related with hardness. Again, it is observed that the Young's modulus of elasticity reduces drastically. That means if the material is reduced from bulk form to nano range, the value of Young's modulus of elasticity is reducing drastically. For example, in magnesium nanocrystal, that is of 1 micrometer grain size, the Young's modulus of elasticity is measured to be 4100 newton per millimeter square. Okay, but if I am making a 12 nanometer grain size, okay, of magnesium nanocrystal, if the grain size of that magnesium nanocrystal is 12 nanometer, its Young's modulus of elasticity becoming 3900 newton per millimeter square. So there is a variation. The elasticity modulus of elasticity reduces from bulk to nano range, and the hardness increases below some hundreds of nanometer range. So if the material is below 100 nanometer, its hardness will start increasing with the reduction in size. Whereas in case of bulk materials, if the grain size is increased, the other way, if the grain size is increased, that means orientation of atoms in particular direction is increased, its hardness will increase. That means if the number of grain boundaries reduces in bulk material, hardness will increase. Okay, whereas in case of nanomaterials, if the size of the material is reduced, the hardness will increase. Okay. So last slide is related with the applications of nanomaterials. Now actually this is completely theoretical part again. There is nothing like explanation, but as per your syllabus, there are 4 applications. First, in the field of medicine, so they are mainly used as a targeted drug, for targeted drug delivery. What it means, the drug is encapsulated in some capsule, and this capsule is having some metallic nanoparticles. Capsule is made with metallic nanoparticles, and which can be operated from outside with the help of electric and magnetic field. Okay, so initially that nano capsule with drug in it is injected in the body, and from outside with the help of electric and magnetic field, it is operated and it is sent to the damaged organ part. Okay, for example, if some cell is damaged in the body, so it is sent to that cell. So if I want to burn a cancer cell, so it is sent to that cancer cell, and when it is injected in that cancer cell, from outside I am operating with the help of electric magnetic field, the capsule will is injected in that cell, and from outside only it will get open, the capsule is getting open, and the drug is delivered in that cell, cancer cell. So because of that drug, the cancer cell will get burned from inside only. So without damaging the other part of the body, and that cell is getting, and that cell is getting damaged or destroyed at that point only. So in this way, it is possible to cure that problem. So in case of medicine, using these nanomaterials are used as for targeted drug delivery. Then electronics, it is used in spintronic devices, then in spin walls, and in SFET, GMR, there is giant magneto resistance in space defense. It is used for making the space suits, which are light in weight, because the weight of these nanomaterials is very, the dimensions are very small, so the suits will have very less weight, so they can carry this easily. in space. And so for the making of space tools, again the strength of this suit is very high, strength of these nanoparticles is very high, hardness is very high, so it will not get damaged because of the environment, and it will have good insulation because the resistivity of these materials is very high as compared to their bulk form, so they will provide very good insulation. Then in details, all these points I am giving in the question banks in detail, so you will have to refer that part. Okay, see my notes that I am sending in the form of question answers. Last point is, in the field of automobile, it is used for the making of long lasting paints. That is, we have seen yes, if the paints are made with the particles having nano size, then as the particles will not get crushed further, the color of that particle will remain as it is. So if I am making a paint from that particles, and if that paint is given on that vehicle body, the paint will remain long lasting, will have long lasting color, it will not change with time. Then for the making of good quality tires, that means the strength of that tires is will remain as it is, because the hardness increases by decreasing the particle size, so strength of that tires will be very high if I am making the tires with the help of nanoparticles. Then they act as a good sensors also. So in this way, these are some applications of nanoparticles in these four fields. What I suppose you just go through that notes which I am providing to you afterwards, and just do this part. Okay, there is nothing like explanation. So with this point, this chapter is completed, nanotechnology, and this is completely theoretical. There is no mathematical expression in this chapter, and only 3 points are there basically. First is the what is the meaning of nanotechnology and nanomaterials. This question will be asked for 4 marks, and 4 or 3 marks with examples. And then second is question is what is quantum confinement? What is the meaning of surface area to volume ratio, and why it is important? Okay, in case of nanomaterials, so that is that may be asked for 4 or 6 marks. Depends again, 5 marks ka bhi puch sakte hai. Then next, any one or two properties or all the three properties in detail for 6 marks. Okay, and then last but not the least, applications, maybe for 6 or 4 marks in your theory paper. So with this unit is completed, unit 6. So just do it from your side also. Okay, all the best. So in this unit, only one numerical based on that velocity expression from non-destructive testing chapter will be there. Okay, so bye.